This video is going to be about relationships, the good ones and the bad ones. This is going to help you overview and help you out with having not only good friendships, but also make you aware of the bad ones. Hi, I'm Susie J. Cobwebs, and this is my channel of having a growing a YouTube channel and business in a writing career with frugal tips and self-care relationship goals along the way. This overview is something like I thought I would bring a little bit extra ideas so we can bond as a team, united as one. This is the time where we improvise our creativity in ways that we could keep in touch with our friends and family. This is also the time that we can make new connections with new friends or the potential strangers that we haven't met yet, which they can become friends too. We'll get to that in one sec. I thought I'd mention that first. Unfortunately, it seems like we're going around in another round of this pandemic, and a lot of people think that it's a bad thing. Which it is, don't get me wrong. But sometimes we have to look at the positive vibes, where the positive vibes survive. We have to look at the positive side of things too. I mean, a silver lining at least. Not only are we staying home, if you are working from home, which a lot of people have that luxury, but there's also those people that are the first line of this consuming COVID germs. Hopefully they're staying healthy too. You also want to give your friends and your family some precious time that they can share with their children and other people. The coolest part of this modern technology is that we are able to talk to people maybe on Zoom, on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. You have all different kinds of video chat systems, or anywhere else where you can talk face to face to your friends and family, and you are able to have that conversation one-on-one with not really spreading the germs. I thought that was really cool. Unfortunately, I think this is the transition that we are going in the world where a lot of people are going to be having to deal with the social media and or transition to the business life with having virtual items such as telemedicine or even virtual visits, conference calls, and stuff like that, because all of these businesses think that this is more savvy, which I also agree, and this will help out productivity, and this will also help out in the business aspect of this. My full-time job actually requires me to work from home. This really lets me see a different perspective. For example, I find, build, and maintain relationships virtually. In the comments below, write down, how did we meet? Are you a friend, a family member, or someone that we met off of social media? Or you want to become a YouTube influencer and I actually got you that way? How did we meet? In the comments below. Do you remember when? Relationships are not only bonds between friends and family, but these also could be romantic or even business. It doesn't matter what type of bond that you have. Each one of these types of scenarios apply. There are many similar ingredients that you would have to remember to keep these bonds. I'll go over a few tips with so you can get the best out of your connections. What do you think is good guidelines to having a good relationship? I know the common guidelines besides love, trust, faithful. When you're looking for a good relationship, what else are you looking for? Can you think of anything else? Write them in the comments. The one good rule of thumb that I like to use is the golden rule. And that is treat others the way that you would like to be treated. I think that's a perfect type of rule that could apply to friends, family, business, and or romantic. This also is in the lines of the possible significant other's children. This is a package deal when you want to be with their mother or aunt or father. I know this could be a little bit challenging, but it could work. And hopefully it works out in the end. Having a good, healthy relationship with someone is not only going to make you healthy and happy, but this connection is going to make a stronger bond as the time goes on. Number two, what type of common interests do you have with these people when you look on Facebook or Instagram or YouTube or any other type of social media platform for this matter? Have you ever looked at that hourglass and then just put in a common interest of yours, and then maybe there is a couple groups out there out in the world that you could maybe be invited to or try to say, hey, I'd like to be involved in your group because I know a lot about this said product or this said hobby. Could we be friends? Could we connect? Could I help you out with some of the information that I have that I've learned along the way by doing this said hobby or this YouTube channel? There is a lot of people out there that have a lot of common interest that could help you, and you can get the information that you need also if you happen to have a question. On the flip side, what do you think the common denominators are when having a bad relationship? Now you're probably wondering, what is she talking about? For example, hereditary. Maybe this is all they know. Hopefully this is something that you could break the cycle. Maybe they can learn new tricks, or maybe help them learn so you could have a happy, healthy relationship. Or maybe they feel that they are not good enough. I know this is a really hard pill to swallow. They need to fix themselves before they could fix others. You just can't up and fix somebody that doesn't know that they're broken. There's going to be other videos on this channel like this, so stay tuned for that. So here's another question for you. What do you need to have a strong bond? A strong bond with someone, not only is it going to fill the void in your heart, but it also lets you trust them wholeheartedly. Besides love, I think trust is the huge factor in a relationship. Now, since we talked about the good and the bad, how can we make our relationships better? What are some ways? Can you write them in the comments below? Learn to trust one another. Although that's easier said than done, you need to learn that sometimes this is the way that you have to build your bond with somebody. And maybe you have to take baby steps to get there, but it will get there. What about, this is a two-way street. And with this type of relationship, it should be a give and take. Maybe not always give, 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 and then you take, take, take. I give, you give. I take, you take. I give, you give. I take, you take. Even though you might not have common interests with this person, you have some type of bond or one or two major interest with each other. That's what actually connected you guys together in the first place. So I would actually strive on those two goals, and then you can broaden your horizons to the other smaller goals that you have for each other. So you have to open up your mind, and maybe I am not into cars the way he is, and he is not into writing like I am. But I am willing to listen to him when he talks about vehicles, and he is willing to listen to me when I talk about writing. I might not understand everything that he says about the vehicles, and he might not understand everything that I say about writing, but we're here to listen to each other, and we're here to maybe possibly give each other advice and feedback and the moral support to each other, because we both love each other and we both trust each other and we both want to see each one of us succeed. So here's my question to you. Do you have any tips or reminders that we can give that you think will be beneficial to a good and or bad relationship? have them in the comments below. And while you're there, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and hit that post notification button so you can see the next time that I post these videos. And till the next time, love you bunches!